This year, Casey and I set the goal to mate 1,000 queens. Well, we're already almost to 100 in that goal, but in order to be able to mate so many queens, you need to be able to, one, graft and have proper nutrition so that you can raise the best quality queens that you possibly can. And two, you need to have a ton of drones so that those queens can also get adequately mated. And three, you need to have space and you need to have a method of how you're going to raise those queens, where you're gonna put them, how you're gonna do it. So I'm gonna give you guys a little bit of a sneak peek into how we're gonna do this. Come on. Oh, and I got stung in the nose yesterday. That's what this big old dot was for. Oh my gosh. I literally felt like I was a clown with a giant red nose. Okay, what you got going on over here?
Looking and mating it.
Oh, you're using that spray?
Yeah, keep them
fine. Oh.
Okay, so what I've been doing.
Yeah.
I'm gonna need a few more. You care of the five I take from?
Nope, any of them.
Which one's got?
That one might be weak. We'll take a look at it. That's the one that I was in when it started storming. Okay. The only thing I don't like about that spray though is it's so strong. Like it burns my nose.
No, it does have a really strong smell to it.
This one. So you're looking for a hive with a ton of bees.
Lid bees.
Ton of lid bees? Oh, okay. Yeah, we have a theory. We've learned that lid bees, I think, always stay lid bees because we always put lid bees in some of our nucs to get them started. And we come back a couple days later and they're still hanging out on the lid.
Right here.
Oh yeah, that's a lot of lid bees. Well, kind of falling off, but.
So they don't fly. They do what they fly.
So that you only have nurse bees left in there?
I want all the flyers to go.
Okay.
So, you're gonna take. You got your mating nuke. Something like this. I have this nice little inner cover. Frames. I usually clean the frames every year just to make sure that they have room to build. Usually cut off the bottom half of it. Give them leave a little starter strip. I'll put grass in here when I put the sugar water in. You can't put the sugar water in until after the bees are put in. And for that reason, because when you tip it upside down, you're gonna kill everything. Right. So the ones that don't go, you see a big old pile of bees. And you have all your bees in there. Kind of knock them down. Make sure you have an adequate amount. Doesn't take a lot. Some people use a cup. I don't use a cup. I just kind of let them ball into what they want.
I'm sure everybody is probably looking at your hands right now thinking that you're crazy with all these bees flying around.
They're friendly. Maybe.
Maybe. I don't know. You just sprayed them and then shook them into a box.
And then some people say you give it a little tap upside down, kind of bring them all to the bottom, and then you can put sugar water in them. But since we're traveling with them, it'll be open.
How do you know how many bees to put in them?
It's supposed to be like a cup.
Oh, a cup of bees? Okay.
But to be fair, an adequate amount of bees. They usually kind of, like, I just kind of got used to it. And then all said bees.
Go back.
Go back where they came from. I don't need any help.
Go back in. So they can become lid bees again.
Right? I think it's all the bees that they just don't like, and they're just like, hey, you're going to go up to the lid, and you're going to stay there.
It's the wax-producing bees, because they have room to produce wax up there, so all the younger ones that are producing wax, they go up there and hang out, and they make wax up there.
Huh.
That's why you see them constantly doing stuff like that.
Yep.
You see how they've already started to... if you remember, I took all that stuff off already.
Yes, you did.
I got to put down...
Are we taking these all to our other yard?
Yep.
Okay. So that's why you're strapping them all up, so we can just do one big trip. I like the way they're all painted.
Thank you.
Did the kids do them, or did you?
No, I didn't.
Oh.
Well, the kids helped with a couple, but for the most part, like the ones with all the roses and stuff like that, that was me.
Gives them personality.
The kids did a lot of the base painting, like just the random colors. They picked the color, and then I gave it the ability to look different than every other house.
Yeah.
And this is before I get my fleet of them. I'm trying to get up to like 500 bees.
Yep.
It's just keeping the woodchucks and other animals at bay.
Yeah. Yeah, he had a trap last year, and we're going to have to find a video or a photo of it. It was hilarious, because what does he put in there as bait? One of those.
It worked. I can't complain if it works. But that's what it wanted. It wanted to have... it wanted these. It wouldn't go after anything else. So no. I put one of these in there and I got it.
Yep. Yeah, we've been having a woodchuck problem lately. Every single time I come out here, if I don't have everything like stacked up nicely, that's like my pile of things I can just pull from, so I'm not like grabbing things and carrying things back and forth to the garage. If I don't put them all like nice and secure, then they end up tearing them all apart, and all the frames will be all over the place, and just keep eating up all the comb. It's fun.
Oh, we're here. Want to see what our next grass frame looks like?
Yes, definitely.
Yeah. See what our takes are gonna be.
That is beautiful. How many took on that one?
I missed one on every frame. All right.
On every, like,
every
rung
bar, they skipped one. But I've noticed that they do that no matter what. They always leave one. I don't know why, but, yeah, no, I hit basically 99%.
That's awesome. And they got that nice white comb because they're starting to flow. Have so many bees on you. I don't know how they don't sting through your pants. So this one we've already taken queen cells out of and put into hives. I'll post up a video of what it looked like before we did that.
33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51. 51 cells. I hit basically 95% on this bar.
Okay.
But
what are you doing when you do that?
I'm checking for viability. Because sometimes they cap them and they die while they're capped. And then they don't grow and you'll end up with an empty cell. But you can watch them grow through the light in it. That's the nice thing about the JZ BZ cups.
Oh.
I do believe that's what these are.
Yes, I think so.
Every so many steps. I like this. It might not be something you have to do, and I don't care if it's a waste of a queen. I like to know what they're gonna look like.
It's like quality checking, just like you do in a factory.
Developing nice and fat. Yeah, it's the equivalent to a teardown in a factory, right?
Yeah, I believe
see,
so.
It seems like we ain't got no mites or any beetles or anything crazy in here. It looks like she's forming well. And I know that it's sad, but that's all I needed to know. One queen out of the next 700 I can make. Oh no, you're going to sacrifice 300 for a mite wash, but I can't sacrifice one to make sure that my queens are coming out properly.
Yeah, yeah. Not wrong. Sacrificing one for the greater good of them all.
Exactly. That also lets me know that they're safe enough to travel with, because they won't fall from the royal jelly.
I know.
You can do it by date. Stinger, stinger, stinger.
Yeah,
stinger,
again, why aren't you wearing stinger, gloves? Okay, guys, stinger, he's been getting headaches, stinger, and I think it's because he's stinger, starting to have like a reaction to getting stung so much. How many times have you gotten stung?
I'm at 805 now.
Yeah, that's not okay. He took Benadryl, and yeah, it knocked him out for the night, but you seem to start feeling better after it. I tried to give him some of my gloves, but then he just tore them, like, instantly, so.
I'm working towards the natural immunity to all these things.
Okay.
I don't know if this is helping or if I'm tying this incorrectly. Maybe your audience can let me know a better way.
I'm sure they're probably looking at it like, what is he doing? That's all right. Give him something to laugh at. are you just throwing this one over to the side because it got into?
No, it's good. It's just, I didn't have any, I have to go get frames for it.
Oh, gotcha, okay. Which yeah, you've been 3D printing, by the way.
That yes, that's what
he's a 3D printer too, guys.
That's what a coon will do when they want it.
Oh.
Worst part was everyone that it got to, they got it to him on the night that they came back mated.
Oh no.
However, fun fact, Zipladoo was the only one out of the attack to survive.
Oh.
That's why she's so super important to me, and that's another reason why I love that genetic line. Like, she didn't leave her box. The other ones flew away.
Uh-huh.
She stayed clustered in her box over the corner, and when I looked, I was like, oh no, and then I found her.
Mm-hmm.
Put her in that hive, and you see what she's done since.
Yeah, she no, she's here. She is kicking butt. She's our main grafting hive right now.
Oh, she's a beast.
We're gonna have to dig into her and show them her soon.
Yes, there will be a video.
And that is that. Then all you do is you just put a, what do? You let them build up some comb in there?
We're going to go home, grab the sugar water for them, and let them kind of get accustomed to their home for 3 days, keep them inside, keep them cool, add a queen cell, and then when she's about to emerge, she'll go out on flight. It's quicker. Obviously, you've seen what it's like getting them made out of a 10 frame is so much longer than mating out of something smaller.
Do not have really good success in 10 frames. 5 frames are a little better. I haven't seen them in the mating nucs yet, so I'm really excited to see that. But you always say you have really good success out of them.
Yeah, almost always. But then again, I get like 99% returns here. Like, if I send out 100 queens, I get 99 of them back. guaranteed, every time.
Yeah, we just found out that, so we finally got to meet the neighbor. We saw him out on some big tractor doing something. We were nervous he was spraying, but then the other day, he saw us out there and called us over, and it turns out that this whole entire time, he's been planting apple trees and pear trees, and he has like 40 or 50 of them over there.
Each of
apples and pears. So yeah, we've been wondering where we're getting all this pollen and nectar from, because we have a lot of bees and they're still pulling in a ton of resources, and now we know.
He started planting them when I started planting bees.
Planting
and he's
bees.
Kept up with me because I pollinate his stuff for free, apparently.
It's a good deal.
Yeah, no, he wants them to keep coming. He asked me if I get more. I'm like, hey, 88's pretty much.
Yeah. Well, hey, we're getting 100 this year.
Oh, we are. Well, he's got access to 100 pollinating hives for his... He's building an orchard, and he decided that because I'm building an apiary. So what do you put next to an apiary? Orchard. I mean, that's just good business. I'm not going to hate on the guy.
Yeah, not wrong.
I mean, like, neighbors working together. That's... Yep. Even if they don't know they're working together.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
It is. It definitely is.
So, no, it keeps us stocked with pollen, and we get... I'm not going to call it apple honey, but it's why that yard here, honey tastes way different than any yard we put it in.
Yeah, it tastes really good here. It tastes like a mixture. I feel like it's the pear that I'm tasting in it.
It could be.
Because it's a... I've had apple honey before. That's what my honey was before where I was previously located. But it has almost like a wildflower, like... I can't even describe it. It's different for sure. It's something you have to taste yourself.
We could send it through the mail, but...
Hey, maybe we'll figure that out eventually.
Yeah, maybe we will. Hmm? We'll let one of you try one. You can tell us what you think.